this foundry has been around since, I'm thinking, the 30s. I've never actually researched when the building was made, but it's been around forever. We are a FEF school, Foundry Educational School. We're a certified FEF school. There's 20 in North America. And it ranges everywhere from us to smaller schools like Pittsburgh State, Northern Iowa, Penn State, Ohio State is an FEF school, Alabama is an FEF school, Alabama Birmingham is an FEF school. So we've got some good company putting out metal casting professionals. Some of them are metallurgical engineers. Ours are more process people. We get jobs like manufacturing engineers, process engineers, quality people, all important to run a foundry. So we are finishing up our Principles of Metal Casting lab, making castings. Normally we pour three different alloys in this foundry with the potential for many more because of the new power supply that we just got in. The power supply is set, ready to go. We still need to do some safety modifications to the floor next to the furnaces. Once we get that done, we'll be fully operational. But we're working on expanding the alloys. We're gonna get into some steel alloys. FlowServe here in town is asking us to do some small run castings for them. What we don't want to do is take business away from foundries that are in business to survive and make money.
Sure.
But if somebody needs one or two of something,
yeah,
we'd be perfect for that. So we're doing some research into pattern materials, pattern tooling, and we're doing some stuff with short run castings. Everybody's printing now. So we're looking and doing some experimentation on the different pattern materials, like PLA. It's a material that is very easily printed. Most of the patterns that we see here, like this one right here, for example, is done with a PLA. This is a project for one of my students that wants to make his own flask because he part-time makes jewelry. Mm-hmm. So he wanted to make his own flask while he was taking my class, so he used that as his project.
Right now, I'm doing two things. I've got a class, a maintenance replacement reliability engineering class, where we are 3D printing a bunch of stuff and basically testing different aspects of that. And one of the things we decided to test on or monitor and record and study is the difference in how a draft allowance affects your casting and your printing on a 3D printer. Like, what's the differences there are. So we're doing. Right now I'm doing like a 0% draft, or 0 degree draft, 3 degree draft, 5 degree draft, and a 7 degree draft, all in the same runner bar, to basically visually show what the difference is between just those few little degrees, how that changes a casting. Because when you're casting, you have to have that angle, that draft angle. Otherwise, when you pull your pattern out of the mold, out of the sand, if it's straight up and down, you're dragging that pattern along, whereas if it's angled, you're pulling it out of it. And that's a really big difference, and a few degrees makes a big difference.
We're also doing some work with another class. We just created a class in maintenance, replacement, and reliability, where students are coming up with a concept part, and then they are going to print it, and then we're gonna cast it. And then we also bought a device called a profilometer, where we can test the surface finish of that casting. So we're doing some pretty cool stuff around here. We're vastly expanding.
We definitely do a lot of hands-on stuff, especially in the MED department. I mean, yesterday I was working for 4 hours in the machine shop over there welding up a bed base or a welding bed base for my senior design projects. And so, yeah, we do that kind of stuff all the time. The reason that's beneficial in, I think, going into industry is that essentially college, I think a lot of people have this misconception that college teaches you how to go out into the workforce and work. But that's not how it works. College is meant to teach you how to learn. when you get out in industry. But having foundations through education, that's where I was able to shorten that learning curve dramatically. That's why I was able to learn those things so quickly. And I think the reason, the hands-on aspects of the MET department specifically and the Foundry, is that we learn by doing. Just like in anything, we learn by doing. And by working in the Foundry, you can read a book about metal casting and you will retain very little. When you go over here and make a metal casting, you'll retain a lot, and a lot of the things that you actually need to retain. You might lose dates that something was, invented, but you'll remember how to do it, right? I think that's why the hands-on is really valuable.
Well, it was always my goal when I first started here was to leave it better than I found it. I'm not going to be here forever. I don't have any desire to be. My desire is not to die in this foundry, But getting the power supply was a big plus. That machine over there with the big purple hopper on top, our no-bake mixer, I got that brand new from Tinker Omega. So that technology was incorporated in here. Upstairs in our sand lab, we've got most of what is used in daily in industry. Mm-hmm. So we're ready to go.